This week's Safety Toolbox Talk is on Berglund-owned and rented equipment on our projects. And on a lot of our projects, you know, here I'm showing you one piece of equipment. Over here we've got another piece of equipment, motorized equipment. We've got a little bobcat there. And then over here we've got a boom lift. And throughout this project there are other pieces of equipment. The reason I wanted to talk about this today is it proper to have a subcontractor or someone else running our Berglund equipment on our projects? Does Berglund take on any liability when others are operating our equipment? Now let's think about that. A subcontractor jumps on a piece of our equipment and damages the piece of equipment and or damages the materials maybe that he's moving, or he runs into a pedestrian's car, he runs into a fellow tradesman, he hurts himself while operating that equipment. The answer is yes, absolutely. And typically we do not want subcontractors using our equipment. Recently on one of our projects, we had a subcontractor using a piece of equipment. He had not gotten permission from our site team to use that equipment, and he damaged that equipment. If he would have hurt himself or he would have hurt someone in the vicinity of that equipment, the entire liability would fall on Berglund Construction Company. So this week's Safety Toolbox Talk, I want discussed, and I want everyone in the company to understand, we do not allow anyone other than Berglund people to operate Berglund-owned equipments and Berglund-rented equipments. That's a rule. That's a policy. Let's take a hard look at that. And then you might say, well, what kind of equipment? Well, we've got lulls. We've got bobcats. We've even got suspended scaffolds on our jobs that our subcontractors are signing hold harmlesses for. And then let's take into consideration a boom lift or a scissors lift or even a beta hoist. There's plenty of pieces of equipment within our organization that we may have other contractors operating, and we, as a company, take on that liability. We need to be careful with that. And then last but not least, if by chance a sub is using our beta hoist or they're using our suspended scaffold, let's make sure that they sign a hold harmless agreement to protect our companies from general liability claims. Thank you. Let's have a safe week.